I was always interested in tools from when I was a little kid. My dad was great. I mean, he showed me a lot of stuff. And, you know, always liked cars. He had an old 51 Chieftain with the Indian on the hood, and I always said that was great. But I was always interested in them, and my dad passed away. I was 11, and the car my mom had, you know, it started breaking down, and that's how I really got into it. You know, she'd be going to these places, paying all these huge bills, and back then it was simple. It was a 1969 Impala, so it was nice to work on compared to some of these newer ones, but, you know, that's really how I got into it. I was trying to think of a name, and I'm like, you know, Bart's Auto. I always call it Bart's Auto. You know, like, Bart's Automotive, you know, Bart's Towing, and my brother's like, I got it. Bart's Automotive and Towing. Bat, blind as a bat, B-A-T. I never had sight, you know, since I was born. I get Popular Mechanics in Braille. I've been receiving it since 1977. I love it. I don't know if I thought about it when I was younger getting into this, as my mom said, you know, you better make sure you still want to do this when you're 50. Well, I'll be 50 in August this year. I still like doing it, but figured by the time I was 50, I'd be sitting in the office, two techs doing it, and I'd just be the boss. I was out in front, I was doing something with a car, and a guy's car stopped right out on Ridgeland. And, you know, people are beeping and trying to get around them, and I actually went out there, and I'm like, hey, just tell me where you're at, because I don't want to get hit by a car. You know, I can't see you. And that probably shocked him, but I helped him push the car. We got it off, and we ended up getting it in the lot here. And he was probably thinking, well, what do you mean you can't see me? What do you, you know? The way the economy affects my business is when it's bad like it is these days, you don't have enough cash flow coming in to buy new equipment or improve on your business. You know, for my 69 Dodge Dart, every time I'd get a little cash or make a little side money, I had a fund, and I called it the Dart Fund, and that helped me buy the different parts for it, the cylinder heads, the camshaft. Well, now the way this economy is, instead of the Dart Fund, it's the Bart Fund to buy food and necessities. 10 years from now, a lot of places like mine may not even be around because you can't do a lot of this stuff because you don't have the equipment that the dealer has. Gotta love it.
All right, guys,
Bart's Auto. It's not like the old 69 Dart with the slant six where you, it's a damp, rainy day and you pump it twice and it don't want to start, and then you're out there putting a screwdriver in the choke and then you might get it going, or maybe the dampness got in the distributor and then you're cursing the car, and you know, now you get in it and turn the key and go. It's great. Destruction. It's gone. You know, this part right here should be out here. So it's, you know, it's totally, it's shoved back. I mean, the car's probably total, I would think. I'm surprised it started and drove in here.
I owe a lot to my parents because from a young age, they didn't discourage me from doing most things a sighted kid would do. They didn't let me sit around and feel sorry for myself. Somebody that I worked on their car, and they posted a thing on the web saying that I went to Bart's Auto. Bart did a great job, took great care of me. You know, thank you, Bart. And it's anonymous, I don't know who it was, but that was really neat, you know, to hear something like that. Every day heroes. Every day heroes like you are every day heroes. Every day heroes. You do.